Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about workspace roles in Power BI services. And all these videos, we have seen like how reports can be published in Power BI services. And we are aware, right, Power BI services is meant for collaboration and sharing. So now, in order to have a collaboration, you need to provide a workspace. The workspace should be shared by multiple people. And if it has to be shared, what kind of roles the other person should have, right? That is what we are going to check out in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So what are the different roles available in workspaces? It's like admin, member, contributor, and viewer. So these are different roles a person can have access to the workspaces. So as the name indicates, admin, he has all the privileges, and viewer is very simple. He can able to view, cannot do any modification as kind of read access. And member and contributor is little tricky, and we will try to find the difference in the Microsoft website itself. Let's move on to the roles in new workspaces in Power BI. As we discussed here, you can see there are four roles, admin and member. So admin can have all the accesses, you can see here, and viewer, he can view and interact with. Okay, that is the two access. Whereas the member and contributor has a minor difference. A contributor is somewhat lesser privilege and more privileged than the viewer access. Okay, the order comes like this. This is having least privilege and this is the second least, then followed by a member, and admin has the highest privileges. So contributor, what he can do, he can do future dashboards and reports on colleagues' home, create and edit and delete the contents in the workspaces, right? What access he do not possess, you can see, manage data set permission, update an app, share an item. This is some point is mentioned below, we will check it out. Publish and unpublish, change permission for an app, add members or others with lower permission. The contributor cannot add members, okay? But a member can add other members as well. So these are the different roles. What is the core difference between member and admin? Allow contributors to update the app for the workspaces. Okay. This is admin feature, that member, if someone with member access, cannot allow a contributor. Okay. So add or remove people, including other admins. You cannot do it in this member access. So with this note, let's try to understand what I'm talking about and we will proceed further. We have this Power BI report and let me deploy it. I'm logged in using AWN NOG1 and have workspace text access. I'm deploying this report over there. I already published, so it's asking me for access, I mean to replace it or not. Yes, I said yes, then I replaced it. So this is the user I have, and you can see this is the workspace. Those who are not aware of what is workspace, I strongly recommend to watch my previous video where I discuss what is this workspace all about. Now this text access is created by Nag user, okay, and he has some reports, and there is another user available for me. He is Mathin, okay. And he doesn't have any workspaces, you can see, no workspaces for himself, and he has its own my workspace also, its contents are empty. So what is the main agenda here? Basically, in a collaborative work environment, a single workspace has to be shared with multiple users, right? So that I Nag as a user publish this report, he is not available, then another user can take up any task or any changes in this report and do his task, right? Or any changes in the dashboard required, he can do it. That is the main purpose of it. So just how to provide access, you can see here access, you can see here the different roles available: admin, member, contributor, viewer, as we see whatever we have. Let's start with giving Mathin viewer access here. Okay, I will say Mathin Varu. Okay, this is the user and I have given him the viewer access. Let's provide access here, then close it. Okay, I have provided the access, and once we go to Mathin login and let's see and refresh the list over here. So this particular workspaces has been given to Mathin now. Now as you can see here, he can able to view the dashboard, I mean to say the read access. So some of the properties whatever as a read user can get is like, he can able to get embed or export access. Hold on a bit, we updated, look for the reports. No, not required. Actually I deployed with the page 2 which is empty, that is fine. So now you can see he can able to see all the reports available in this dashboard, and this is the access rights he can able to provide. So as a read user, he do not have access or privileges to do other settings, right? What do you mean by other settings? He cannot able to add other members in this dashboard, right? So you can see this user have a access bar where he can able to add members because he is the admin NAG user. Okay, that provision itself not available. Then what I need to do now, I will change him to contributor. Okay, or let us do it as a member, then close it. Okay, I have closed it and go here and request access here. Now you can see when I do a member, he can able to add other members in this group. So there are other members in the group. It's lags user. Let us see whether he can able to add. So he can able to add other members. So for him, he can do any changes or not, he can do it, right? So these are the different access mechanism. So to aware what are the different roles used to have, right? Some members should have only the read access to the workspace. Some members should have only edit access to the reports. And some of the members as admin, you need to focus on these two roles. Okay, the administrative part, you can go for admin and member. And some people who has role do not have a provision to give access to the reports, right? Only they need to contribute to the development part. Okay, these two are for the, I mean, contributors for the development. Viewer can be a business user, data analyst, whoever it can be. So based on this sheet or this page, you can provide the respective access so that a single workspace can be shared between multiple users and you can collaborate and you can productively work on the same reports. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. And do remember that data is your asset.